Okay, next match. I won the die roll, but gonna give it to him again, so we have alternating die rolls. Both on the play equally often. And after that we're gonna do a short wrap-up in a Skype conference with Frederick to talk about how the matchup feels from his side and how he sideboarded. Yes, we kind of have to keep this, but I'm uncertain. I mean, the hand's not great, but I'm not sure if we can mulligan a hand like that. Especially with that deck, since it kind of needs its resources quite a lot. I'll just explain to him why I choose to draw first, since I didn't tell him that in the beginning, so he was a bit confused. And he also clearly didn't pay attention to who was being on the play and who not. That just panned out like naturally before. Yeah, this hand is developing pretty poorly. At least we have a company that helped the hand a lot. That hand just went from really bad to pretty solid. Really needed that. Ooh. Well, there goes game one, I think. This is just so hard to beat without removal for this placer. So let's try and keep one husk in play. But yeah, this placer is probably gonna dominate that game. Okay, that's weird. I feel like he kind of should have used his placer here. I think that is a mistake. But I'm not sure. Okay. not the greatest. Okay, so I guess we sack this guy to flip our Liliana. And then get it back. Okay. Let's see if that's gonna be enough. Kind of doubt it. But at least we have kind of an interesting game now. Once you can activate this place or twice, we're basically dead. So it needs a colorless land. There is the land and the colorless land. Because you can fetch a waste. That was a pretty good discard, actually. But yeah, I mean, we can't really attack, I think. We can try. But yeah, I mean, he can basically just block one, bounce the other. Yep, I think probably attacking was even worse than not attacking. I think it's probably better to let him just exile the zombie rather than let him bounce a husk and eat the front side of two blister bots. Yep, I mean, this is just terrible no matter how you twist it. That's why these plays are so powerful. There's these games that are kind of like awkward and not looking that great, and you're stalling, and then you have Displacer and Reflector Mage, and suddenly no matter who you're playing against, it looks a whole lot better if they play creatures as well. Or actually just dominates the game and you can't lose. So yeah, we're basically dead. We can't win this game. Now that he can activate twice. There's no point in dragging this out any longer. I wonder if it might be right to just bring in 4 Transgress here to like hit his companies, arrogances, and displacers. Oh, that's really bad. I feel like we have to keep it because any land lets us play visionary. That's not the perfect land because it's tapped, but it's a land. And it's also a black land that lets us play our transgress, which is pretty good. But yeah, it seems like we are gonna lose this match. Would be surprised if we managed to win this game post-board. Getting massacred. Now he might even have company. Yep. Looks almost like it. Let's find out, I guess. Wow. Yeah, I mean, this game is over. He got us. Okay, this was a very demoralizing and lopsided match. He just crushed us while we stumbled a bit. And even if he wouldn't have stumbled, his draw would have been really good. Okay, like, I'm gonna be back with the wrap-up with Frederick. And we'll talk about how we both feel about the matchup and talk about how he sideboarded. See you in a moment.